All right, guys, we're going to the north right now. We're going to New England to fish for a variety of species for a few days. We're getting out of Philadelphia because Philadelphia's beat. It's hot. I don't know, it's 97 degrees out where we're driving. No, 99.
Yeah.
So yeah, we're trying to find some cooler weather, some cooler fishing. I'm gonna be trying to catch some bonito. Tan's more looking for the scup.
You can keep 30 scup. 30's a lot. A day, 30 a day, we can keep 60.
If we're good, we'll keep 180 scup.
That's a lot. That's a cooler full of scup.
That's too much.
That's not too much.
Blackfish, maybe sea bass.
Flounder.
Get lucky, get a striper.
Yeah.
Probably guaranteed some brigalls. Maybe a sea robin or two.
You gonna keep the sea robins?
Oh no. Porgy or bust. Pork chops.
Made it this far on day one. It's like 7 o'clock right now.
This is New Jersey.
Tan is starting to realize it's not New Jersey here. Had some interesting experiences along the way, mainly at Wendy's that had gone corrupt. Inedible food, but yeah, we're here. Gonna fish for whatever we can catch. All right, so we made it to the fishing grounds just as the sun's getting low. We've been here for about 10-15 minutes. Not seeing any sign of bonito. No bait fish getting worked. No splashes. We're resorting to scup fishing. We got like no time right now, so I'm trying to scup fish. Ooh, where's the fish? Let's see if we can get the first fish of the day. Oh no. No. Unbelievable. All right, well that's a dogfish. That could be like the start of a very bad trip right there. Dogfish is not a good fish. Let's try for a scup now. That could be a really bad omen. Could be some kind of curse. Alright guys, it's 10:30 in the morning. Didn't get the early start we were hoping for, but we're out here now. Gonna fish today. I'll actually be able to fish all day as opposed to yesterday where we got nothing. So we'll get a good lay of the land, see what's going on here. Hopefully some sea bass or tog or flounder, bonito. So we got clear weather, light winds. Water's pretty clean. Good 5 feet of visibility. No tunoids. Tan's throwing the squid. What's he got? Oh yeah! Keeper scup. That's what you need there, keeper scup. Tan's got our first keeper scup of the trip. We already got a short flounder. I'm throwing a bucktail hoping for a flounder. If there's no flounder bite, I mean I've already given up on bonito. If there's no flounder bite, I'm gonna have to resort to scup. There's one. There's a flounder. Let's see what we got here. It looks like a short. It's good though. Little short flounder. Hit the 3/4 ounce spro and the gulp jerk shed. That's what I'm throwing. Just this. Let's get a bigger one. Number two, cookie cutters. Cookie cutter 13 inches, 14 inches. Another flounder. Still on the gulp and the bucktail. Little bigger flounder. Getting up there, not gonna be worth measuring. But I got this cool color, they're almost orange. It's like this blue water. I don't know. This is what flounder out on the wrecks and the reefs, like offshore flounder in New Jersey, look like. Up here, they have the same look. Went through one pack of gulp, probably in 2 hours of fishing. I think I got five short fluke, maybe four short fluke. Definitely missed one or two. I have a lot of other bites. A lot of other bites from sea bass and scup. Alright, maybe we'll get one this cast. Something. Oh, bigger flounder. Keeper? Maybe. It's gotta be 18 inches. And my tape measure is back there. I'm pretty sure that's 18 inches. Yeah, that's a keeper. That one's gonna be over 18. I don't have a measuring tape, but I'm gonna assume he's keeper, based on the fact that he's looking like a keeper. So, and the way I'm jigging this right now is I'm casting it out, letting it sink to the bottom. The water's probably 15 feet deep, so it takes a good 20 seconds to get down to the bottom. This 3/4 ounce jig, and once it hits bottom, I'm just with the retrieve, just kind of popping it, and letting it fall. You know, slow, and then, oh, look at that, that was a bite. We're just working it along the bottom and just off the bottom. Primarily, you know, most of the time the jig is gonna be off the bottom, you know, anywhere from 1 to 2 feet off the bottom is good, and then just like let it fall, let it sit, let it hit bottom again. A lot of times the flounder will follow the jig up to the rocks before hitting it. So a lot of times you'll get hit close to shore. And it doesn't necessarily have to be on the rocks. Look at that. See, just as I was saying. Right, whoa. That thing hit right up on the rocks. And yeah, sometimes you might think that, you know, the flounder's hanging out in the rocks, which sometimes he is, but more often than not, they're following it in. Following it in from far out, you know, and if you're fishing from shore, like wading a beach or something, same thing, you know, you'll find that a lot of your hits come close to shore. I'm out of gulp. I'm gonna go measure that keeper. I hope it's a keeper. Walk back, get my stuff. All right, let's get a measurement on this fish. Let's hope he's 18 inches. I am, you know, 100% sure he's 18 inches. Oh, 19 and a half inches. All right, yeah, definitely a keeper. Tan buoy is so far down these rocks. He's literally a 1/4 mile away. Probably too far for me to walk just to put this flounder in the ice bucket. So what I'm gonna do is get some of this leader material that I have. 80 pounds, something, there we go. I'm gonna use this as a stringer to keep this fish cool between the rocks and the water. Oh yeah, just like this. Keep him out of the sun, right in between the rocks. This Gatorade has been in my bucket all day. It's warm, it's unfortunately warm. And I'm just gonna slug it, because I'm thirsty. I got two gulps left, well, three gulps left. I've gone through one pack already. This is my second pack. And I'm gonna try out here. I haven't yet to make it this far. Out the jetty. My theory is, you know, that this would be like the best fluke fishing. Look at that, some fresh bird crap. We're getting slippery. It's getting a little slippery. Test it as far as I can. Yeah, there's gonna be some fluke. It's gonna be some fluke here. The tide's coming in, so this is all about to turn to ice right now. Like, as it gets wet, this algae that's on here is like ice. I probably shouldn't go out there. I'll have to fish here. We'll fish right here. Wow, there's a lot of little tiny flounder out there. I'm getting a lot of bites from what feels like little tiny flounder that I've been catching. Like right there. Well, let's see what we got here. Same size. Tons of them. Tons of them. Get close to the rocks. And a lot of flounder out here. A lot of flounder. Short flounder. A lot of short flounder. With two packs of gulp. This is our second pack, last one. And I don't know, maybe we can get a big doormat flounder. That's what we're going for. Let's make it happen. I was hoping to get two keeper flounder today. So far we got one keeper flounder. This one's really dark. This is a crazy colored flounder right here. That thing is red. It looks like he's red. That is an awesome flounder. He's so thick too. Beautiful northern flounder. He's changing colors right now. Changing colors before our very eyes. Fine looking fish. No. Got like an old crab pot or something. Well, that might be the end of the gulp and the flounder. All right, I got no gulp. What I'm gonna do, tie on a 2-ounce bucktail. This is a 2-ounce bucktail. I'm gonna put a 7-inch zoom fluke on it. And this should, hopefully produce a flounder, like a big flounder. Let's see. Oh, son, there's something good. That's a keeper flounder, I think. Oh, that's a nice flounder. Oh no, he's in the rock. Oh yeah, we're not gonna get this frickin' flounder, dude. Oh boy, it's a nice fluke. Look at that fluke. Woo, baby. Look at that, 7-inch zoom fluke, my friends. Gets you a nice flounder. 2-ounce bucktail, 7-inch fluke, no gulp, you know, that's what you gotta do. 22.5. Yep, 22.5-incher, that's a solid shoreline flounder. And we're gonna put him on the stringer. That's good stuff, guys, that's good stuff. Gonna rope up this flounder. Oh no, I'm just gonna let him sit here in the shade. Rope him up and leave him in the shade. We need to find a better spot for these, actually. Let's find a better spot for these. Keep them nice and fresh right here in this water. Yeah, that's the spot. Probably just tie him to this pole. Hot dang, look at that. Gonna tie him to the pole. Might have to retie. That thing really got me in the rocks there. I didn't think I was gonna get him. See how frayed we are. See, I got this thing called laziness. And like, this is frayed pretty bad, but at the same time, alright, yeah, it broke. So yeah, good call. Let's retie. Let's get a new rig on here. Let's get a whole bunch of new leader on here. Alright, so I like to keep it simple, man. I like to keep it real simple. This is a 1/4-pound spool or a 1/2-pound spool of Andy monofilament. It's not fluorocarbon. It's nothing special. It's actually like $11 for probably 300 yards, 400 yards, maybe 500 yards. I don't know how much line is on there. It's a lot though. 2, 7, I'm gonna use 8 feet, 9 feet a liter, just because of all the rocks around here. Gotta use some mono to protect you against the rocks. All right, so my fluke has gotten pretty beat up. I think by Flounder, I think by Flounder we're beating it up. And I'm gonna put on, maybe I should go with this. Is that too big? Too big for a Flounder? We'll find out. I'm gonna try it. I don't think that they'll be pecking the tail off of this one. Forget what these are called. Ronzi? Yeah, I think it's a Ronzi. See how the fluke, see if the fluke respond to the Ronzi. Nice Flounder. Oh yeah. That's a keeper. Come on. Whoa. Yeah, baby. Look at that, another keeper fluke. 21 inch fluke. Look at the Laureate. That's a 10 inch plastic, 9 inch plastic. That's crazy. I'm gonna go put him on my stringer. Don't let him get away. Oh crap. Crabs. Little crabs eating our Flounder. Good and bad, you know? Crabs are good for, good tog bait. All right, let's hit that. Didn't even measure this one, but this one was 19 and a half, so this one's got about an inch on them. Oh yeah. We got crabs coming out of the Flounder. That's what I like to see. How many other crabs are in there? Dude, they're inside his stomach. What the hell? What's going in his stomach? In there. Alright, use Flounder. Get this back in the water. Even though the crabs are gonna eventually eat them. Look at all those crabs we just got. Alright, so this is actually quite an interesting situation. One Flounder on an entire pack of gulp, one keeper Flounder, 19 and a half inches. Start using soft plastics, and I get two keepers, no shorts. Both keepers are decent size, over 20 inches. Oh, here we go. Oh, no way, that's not a Flounder. Damn, son. Random snag out there. Looks like this one's not coming back. I think it's gone. All right, well, we lost the 2 ounce jig. I think that might have been a 1.5 ounce now that I think about it. That was like a very cheap jig from Walmart, and it's gone. Got my shock leader back. Let's take a look at what we got in the crab trap right now. I feel like there's a lot of crabs on there. Oh my gosh, a lot of crabs. Too bad I lost them all, they all got away. All right, should be like a bunch more. All right, we got a lot of crabs, kind of a lot of crabs, but they're trying to escape. So the Flounder are getting eaten by these crabs, but it's not a big deal. They're not eating the meat. They're just eating the gut pockets. Like the Flounder is still perfectly intact. I'm gonna try to get a lid for this. See how Tambui's doing right now. He says that this was at 3 o'clock. It's 4:44 right now. At 3 o'clock, Tan said that he was almost demoralized. Says tough times at 2:30. I mean, he's fishing for scup with squid. And yeah, he's having some tough times. Tambu is fighting something as we speak. What's he got? Oh, he's got a scup. How's the scup fishing? Started moving?
Is it moving or is it?
Yeah. I got 3 flounder.
Damn, dude.
Damn, son.
What's up with those holes then?
I killed them. Oh. Where's the scup?
There's that many.
3-4 scup?
What do you think about this one?
I got tape measures.
They're starting to bite again.
Check out what I got though. I had the flounder in the water.
Oh, shit.
Yeah.
What's your tape measure?
Here.
Oh, yeah.
Keep up?
It's 10.5 inches.
10.5 inches.
Yeah, look.
Oh, yeah, he's a keeper. Here.
Dude, I threw back like 4 or 5 like these.
Cooler's looking good now. Except there's no ice in there. Tan's northern kingfish. Yeah, that's a northern kingfish, all right. Got the colors in the spine. This thing. Oh! Think we can get him. Yeah, this is good crab bait. Damn, just like that, disappears into the rocks. Look at that. Well done. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Oh, there's glass breaking down there.
It's pretty dangerous.
Yeah, but it's worth it because that's a nice kingfish. That's a nice... That's totally different than the ones in South Jersey. Totally different. Yeah, northern kingfish. We were catching southern kingfish.